Ellarigu namaskara, welcome and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is just the eyes. Yes, the rest of my face is bare, I'll do it later, but it's just the eyes. I posted this look last week when I went out. I did this look and I asked on Snapchat if you guys were interested to see this look. Let me get you in closer. So this is the look that I wore on that day. So that is the look that I wore out. I wore a cold shoulder top, but I was too lazy to wear. So I'm just wearing my backpack shirt. So I'm going to try my best to recreate it. And I'm using this Makup Revolution Iconic 3 palette. This is like my favorite palette. I have done 5 tutorials using this. I did a 1 palette tutorial week. I will link it down below. So I was just playing with it that day and that look was just beautiful. I loved it and a lot of people also wanted to see. So that's what I'm going to do today. Also, I might change up the lip. I'm not feeling the red lip today. So it's pretty easy. Let's get started. Let me know if you like this angle better. It's like up close and personal. I'm starting with the Essence Eye Heart Stage Eye Makeup Base. This is really good and it makes the colors pop and it also helps in making sure that your eyeshadow lasts longer. To set that, I'm using this Miss Claire translucent powder. Because this eyeshadow base is a little tacky, it's better to set it. And to set it, I'm using this Ankita eyeshadow brush. So last week when I did the look, I actually had tape on, but I'm not able to find my tape, so we'll just roll without it. I'm using the Makeup Revolution Iconic 3 palette, like I mentioned. I'm going to first pick up this shade from the palette. And I'm going to apply this all over my crease as the first transition color. Next up, I'm picking this shade from the palette, which is slightly deeper, but almost the same color, but it's slightly deeper. And I'm going to use this to deepen my crease. I'm using a Pune store smudge brush, by the way. And then going back in with that same fluffy brush, which is from Born Pretty Store, I'm just going to blend it a little more. Next, I'm going in with this last but one shade. I'm going to use this to further deepen up the crease and also put it in the inner half as well as the outer half, leaving the middle bare. And then going back in with that same fluffy brush, I'm going to blend it a little bit. Now to further intensify it, I'm going to take this shade from the palette and I'm going to apply it in the same places where I applied the previous color, except much lower. Make sure you tap off the excess with this because it's like really dark. Again, I'm going back in with that same fluffy brush and blending it out. Blending is the key to any nice eye makeup. So there, as you can see, it's pretty much done and all we need to do is fill a shimmery color in the center. For that, I'm going to pick up this shade from the palette. It's a beautiful shimmery taupe shade and I'm going to apply to the center of my lid. You could wet your brush. I'm using the same Ankita shader brush and I'm going to apply it only to the center of my lid. And then I'm going to take a smaller blending brush like so and I'm going to blend it so that there is no harsh definition between the darker color and the shimmery color on the lid. I'm going to pick up this first shade from the palette and I'm going to use it to highlight the brow bone. Next, I'm taking the Iconic Kajal in the shade black and I'm going to apply this very close to the top lash line and then I'm going to blend it out with the help of this Pune store eyeliner brush. I'm only going to apply the Kajal in the center and then use that to spread into the inner as well as the outer corner. You could actually do a wing liner with this, but it would take away from the halo eyes. This is just to give a very slight definition to the eyes. It looks like you have liner, but you don't. Again, I'm going back in with that same brush and I'm going over it just to make sure that it doesn't look like I have a liner, but it gives the illusion that there's a liner there. That's all we want. And then we can move on to the lower lash line. Okay, so I did realize that the eyeliner was not like blended properly. It's this new lens that I've zoomed in so close, it's making it really weird. Anywho, I've done the rest of my face, and now for the lower lash line, I'm using the same Lakme Iconic Kajal, and I'm going to run it along my lower waterline. If you want, you could tight line, but as you all know, I'm too scared to do that. So I'm just going to run this along my lower lash line. Next, I'm going to pick up this shade, which is the second darkest shade that we use for transition, and I'm going to run it along my lower lash line. And then I'm picking up this shade, which is the third shade that we use for transition, and I'm going to run it along my lower lash line again. And then with the help of the same fluffy brush, I'm just going to blend the two together. For the inner corner highlight, I'm going to pick up that same first shade and I'm going to put it in the inner corner. Next, I'm going to curl my lashes. Next, I'm using the Essence Get Big Lashes Mascara onto my lashes. You could use falsies, that's totally optional, but you guys know I don't use falsies like at all. Maybe I should start using them. So with that, the eyes are complete. Next, let's move on to the lips. Now, as for the lips, when I wore this look, I wore a red lipstick, which was the Maybelline lip gradation in the shade red too. But today I wanted to switch up the lip color. I wanted to keep it pretty monochromatic. So I'm using this Colorpop Ultra Matte X Lippie Stick in the shade Cami. So there we go. That is what the finished result looks like. The lips, I kind of like it. So it's sort of different. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. The rest of my face, I did it off camera because it was just like, I mainly wanted to focus on the eyes and a little bit on the lips. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. I have all my social media links down in the description box below. Feel free to follow them. And yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Till then, bye. Oh, let's put the heart here.